Our solar system is home to one star, the Sun, which together with about 100 billion other stars call the Milky Way galaxy home. A rough estimate suggests there are about 10 trillion galaxies in the universe. If you multiply that with the Milky Way's 100 billion stars, it turns out our universe has 1 septillion stars, that's 1 with 24 zeros after it. A 2014 study, including astronomers from Caltech, concludes as many as half of all stars in the universe exist outside galaxies. You've probably already heard about rogue planets, planets that don't orbit around stars but instead roam free through interstellar space on their own. Just like rogue planets, there are rogue stars that are not bound to a host galaxy but instead roam free through intergalactic space. It turns out the universe is filled with these fellas that have escaped the gravitational pull of their home galaxy and are moving toward the intergalactic void. Such stars can also be called hypervelocity stars because one would need to move at an enormous speed to be able to escape the gravitational clutches of a galaxy. One of the ways these stars gain high speeds is when they gravitationally interact with black holes. Such interactions can boost them up to speeds double or even triple that of the Sun, which moves around the Milky Way at 200 kilometers per second, or at an average speed of 448,000 miles per hour. Just over the past decade, astronomers have spotted a couple dozen of these hypervelocity stars. Most of these lie in the Milky Way's outer halo, at least 150,000 light-years from the galactic center, and move at velocities of 700,000 miles per hour. Such a star could zip from Earth to the Moon in about 20 minutes. Another way how rogue stars could escape their galactic home is when galaxies collide and merge. Such mergers could fling stars into intergalactic space at crazy speeds. The 2014 study that concluded half of the stars in the universe are homeless came when astronomers investigated the extragalactic background light, which is the amount of all light emitted by stars in the universe throughout history. Previous research had detected fluctuations in this light that were initially thought to be the result of primordial galaxies, galaxies that exist so far away from us and very early in the infant universe that we have not been able to detect their light yet. But then, since the visible and ultraviolet light from stars and primordial galaxies should have reddened over time, as the universe expanded in a phenomenon known as redshifting, scientists found that these fluctuations were too bright and blue to come from primordial galaxies. And this implied that these fluctuations may come from something called intrahalo light, which is created by stars flung into intergalactic space during galactic collisions. What researchers found is that there was as much light from these intergalactic stars as there was from stars inside galaxies. This meant there could be an equal number of stars existing outside galaxies as those lying in galaxies. According to researchers, this discovery could solve the so-called photon underproduction crisis, which suggests an unusual amount of ultraviolet light appears to be missing from the universe. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.